Welcome. We're now ready to take a look at what's called a weighted mean. So a weighted mean is used when we consider some data values to be more important than other values, and so we want them to contribute more to the overall average. All right, so we're going to talk about a weighted mean by looking at an example of your grade point average. So I always love this topic because, of course, as a Long Beach City College student, your grade point average is certainly important to you. So we're going to try to dive in a little bit and help you understand what your grade point average represents. So it will be a weighted mean of your grade points, where the weights are the units or credit hours for a course. All right, so when you take a class and earn a letter grade, you're earning points for it. So A's are worth 4 points, B's are worth 3 points, C's are worth 2 points, D's are worth 1 point, and an F in a class earns you 0 points. But the letter grades are not all necessarily equal in terms of their contribution to your overall GPA, because we weight the points based on how many units a course is worth. So let's take a look at this example. So I have my student here that took statistics and earned an A, yippee for that. So that gives the student 4 points. So A's are 4. So X will represent our variable, in this case, the grade earned. All right, but what happens is the units of the course, we'll call that the weight. So how much sort of impact it has on your GPA is affected by the units. So I'm going to come over here to what I call my bucket of points. So when you earn an A in a 4-unit class into your point total, you don't just get the A once, you get 4 A's basically. So that's what the weight is doing. So in total here in my bucket of points, 4 + 4 + 4 + 4, you just got 16 points for an A in statistics. So to get to that 16, we can just take X, your grade, times the weight, the units of the course, and 4 × 4 gives us those 16 points. All right, so let's move on to sociology. So this student got a C in sociology. Those are worth 2 points. So C's are worth 2. And the weight of the course, the number of units, was 3. So into my bucket here, you're going to get 2 points, but you'll get 3 of them. So it will be 2, 2, 2. And that total you can get by taking 2 × 3. So now I have 6 points put into my total points. All right, and then kinesiology, this student unfortunately failed. So F's worth no points. Fortunately, it's only a 1-unit class. So into my bucket over here, I would get a 0, and that would occur just once. And of course, 0 × 1 is 0. All right, so my bucket over here represents the total points earned for the student this semester. And so in this bucket, if we add up all those points, we can do that here on our table by saying, what is the sum of these X times W values we just calculated? So 16 plus 6 plus 0 is 22 points. So in total here, if we added those up, the student had earned 22 points. All right, and then we need to turn that into an average. So these are total grade points. Grade point average says that we're going to take those 22 points and divide them equally among the total number of values here, which are the total of the weights. So in this bucket, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I have 8 values. So when I add the weights, that's the 8. So the sum of the weights is 8 units the student is taking. So we're going to take the points and spread them evenly among 8 units. And that's what your GPA is. So let's write the formula over here. So GPA, when we add the grade times the units of the course for every course, and we divide that by the sum of the weights. So what we're doing here is taking the total points and dividing it by the number of units. So that's what it represents in the context of a grade point average, that formula. All right, so we have 22 points. We're going to divide that among 8 units total. And 22 divided by 8 is 2.75. And oftentimes GPAs are reported to 2 decimal places, so I'll leave that at 2.75. So for this student, a 2.75 overall GPA, so a 2 and 3, so that's somewhere between a 2 and a 3, and that's somewhere between a C and a B, so sort of a high C, getting closer to the B mark. All right, and then we're going to modify this question slightly. So it says, what if all courses had been of equal weight? So if they had all been weighted equally, and another way of saying the same question is, what if they were all the same number of units? So no one grade counted more into the GPA than the other, how would that affect the student's GPA? So we'll call this the unweighted GPA, treating the courses as equals. So in that case, we don't think about weights at all. We're just going to say, in total, what were the grade points? So we would just add, now we would just add that X column. So we would just want to know how many points they earned without regard to weights. So in total, that would be 6 points. And then we would divide by, if those courses are weighted equally, there's 3 courses. So we would just divide that by the number of courses the student is taking. So that's how we calculate the mean without regard to weights. All right, so in this case, 6 points, and the student is taking 3 courses. So that makes their GPA a 2.00. All right, so why is their regular GPA, we always assume weighted when we say GPA, why is their GPA higher with the weighted mean versus unweighted? Well, if we take a look at these grades, that A in statistics, I want it to be worth more for a good GPA than my grade in kinesiology, because this student failed kinesiology. So by weighting that, for example, that A and that F equally among these grades, it's pulling down that GPA. So the GPA is higher because an A in a 4-unit class, that 4 units, has a bigger influence on the overall GPA. Okay, so we'll do one more here. And I didn't put any names of courses in, so we'll just sort of make some up. So here's the way it works again. X represents the grade earned in a class. W, the weights, represents the units the course is worth. And then when we multiply those values, that's giving us our total points. And let's go to it. All right, so I'm just picking some classes. So let's say the student is taking sociology and they earn an A. A's are 4 points. It's a 3-unit class. So in total, so 4 times 3, they would get 12 points for sociology. All right, and then a 1-unit class. So I'm just gonna pick counseling. I'll just abbreviate here, counseling. So it's an A, but as a 1-unit class, that will earn 4 points. So earning more for an A in sociology than for your A in counseling because of the units. All right, and then a B. So I'm gonna pick psychology. Just abbreviating here, psychology. Let's say a student earns a B. B's are worth 3 points. It's a 3-unit class. So 3 times 3 earns the student 9 points. And then an F, in a 5-unit class, so that's not good. So of all these courses, 5 units, that one's going to have the biggest impact on the GPA. So an F there is very much not good because you don't earn any points for an F. So I don't want to pick any particular course here to earn an F in. I'm calling it the mystery course. So whatever this course was that the student just failed, getting a 0 in a 5-unit class, 0 points. And then let's do some totaling. So let me start with the weights. So this particular student, this tells us how many units they were taking. So 3 + 1 + 3 + 5. That's 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So 12 units. And then the sum of the, so capital sigma, the sum of the X times W values would be the total points in their bucket, so to speak. So 12 + 4 = 16 + 9 = 25. All right, so GPA. So it's the sum of the X times W values for each course, and we divide by the sum of the weights. So 25 points divided by 12 units. So 25 divided by 12. And then in terms of rounding here, we're going to round to 2 decimal places as needed. So 2 decimal places would be 2.08. All right, so in terms of a letter grade, 2 grade points, that's like a C. So this is just a little above a C average, even though the student got an A, and a B. So that's seeming a little bit low for their average, but it's because that 5-unit F is really kind of bringing down that GPA. So what we're going to do is take a look at what would have happened if the student had decided to withdraw from their 5-unit class prior to the withdraw deadline. So withdrawing from a class is always something that students need to take a lot of thought in before making any decision, and we won't go into all the details here about pros and cons of withdrawing from a class that you might potentially get an F in. We're just going to assume that this student has decided to withdraw. So basically, this mystery course is gone, and we want to see how that would have affected their GPA. So withdrawing from a course does not affect the GPA. So GPA, all right, so it's still going to be the sum of the X times W values, giving the points, divided by the sum of the weights. Always good to keep practicing writing formulas and symbols. It makes the course easier as we move along, as you're getting comfortable writing. And then let's see what would have changed. So rather than writing this whole table over again, let's just look at the points. So the X times W values. So without my mystery course here, and I'll go ahead and just draw a line through it. So without that course, when we add up the points that the student is earning, they're still earning 25 points because they didn't get anything for the mystery course anyway. So that numerator is still 25. What's going to change is the denominator, because now instead of dividing it by 12 units, when we add the weights without that 5, that's going to be 7 units. So instead of taking 25 points and spreading it among 12 units, we're taking 25 points and spreading it just among 7 units. And now that's going to bring the GP up quite high compared to what it was before. So that's a 3.57. So that's between a B and an A in terms of points. I call it like a maybe a B plus. So that's that impact I'm trying to show with getting that 0 in a high unit, 5-unit in this case, course. All right, there you go. I hope that helps you understand your GPA a little bit better if you hadn't thought about it before.